you trust the person who's trying to make you their customer, then you will become their customer. I think you don't need to be afraid of things. You see, I had a young man who lived with me. He was my sort of upatar many years ago, he was a bit of a troubled young man at the time, and he ended up on the social services, and they kind of almost written him off. But he was actually quite gifted, and he stayed with me for a while. And he was a very good cook and quite a gifted young man. And when he left me, he got a job as a chef somewhere. And he's continued ever since, so far as I know, working as a chef. And very occasionally, he gets in touch with me over the years. I mean, he stayed with me as my upatar about nearly 30 years ago. And he's married and all that. And he rang me up one day. He came to see me. And he said to me, he lives a long way from where I am, so he came down to see me. And he said he'd never taken the refuges and precepts properly. So he wanted to. So he took the refuges and the precepts. And then off he went back to wherever he lives and went back to work. And then a few months later, he rang me up and he was in a bit of a panic because, he needed to keep his job. And there it was, he was a chef. And the proprietor of the restaurant suddenly had bought, or presented him with, a bucket of mussels and expected him to cook them. And he said, I've just taken the precepts. I said, what am I going to do? He said, I can't lose my job. And someone had said to him, well, just go ahead and cook them and make merit afterwards. I said, no, that's all right. You must keep the precepts. I said, look, don't panic. Go and talk to your employer and explain to your employer your predicament and explain that you've taken the precepts, you can't kill anything. Anyway, he rang me back a few hours later. He was amazed. He spoke to his employers, and that's right, sent them back. And you just never know. When you treat people well and do your job well, and you're a valued employee, then, just be upright and honest and people respect it. And I believe also that they respect it when you are secure in life. So if you are nervous about it and you're not very secure and not very sure whether you're committed to keeping the precepts or not, then you might be bullied. You might be told, well, you don't do it or forget your cards. But I'm certain that if you are secure, if you are honest about it, you go on. I think you have to have that faith and commitment. Thank you. it's true. He does as well. because it isn't very interesting. And this is difficult, especially if you are of an active kind of mind that is used to interesting things. When you just try and keep your mind on your breathing, it is not very interesting. And if your mind won't take an interest in the object of meditation, then it won't develop it. So you have to find something that is interesting. In the field of Buddhist practice, first of all, Buddhist meditation is of these two kinds, samatha and vipassana. And actually they cross over a bit, really. And it's not quite as absolute the division as that. And the two support each other. So people like Uncle Charlie will teach samatha or vipassana. He didn't teach just vipassana or just samatha. But there are some groups that teach just samatha, and some that advertise themselves as teaching just vipassana. But actually there's a bit of a crossover. So if you practice any of the 40 subjects in the Visuddha Marga, which are all samatha practices really, there is a benefit in terms of understanding. If you concentrate your mind on the parts of the body, well, it will gradually help you to understand the nature of your body and to be less attached to your body and things like that. But those practices are essentially there to concentrate the mind and to keep the mind, if you can, absolutely alert. But a lot of people have difficulty with that, and then they give up. But luckily there is another way, and the other way is, yes, you try to concentrate, but you also watch every time your mind is disturbed. And there is a great trick in this, but it's worth developing, because you know, when boredom comes into your mind, watch that. And for Charlie, we'll talk about this as well. There are some techniques, but he also talked about this. So when you feel bored, pay attention to